Yeah. Praise the Lord, Father, we thank you, we give you praise. We magnify your great name for what you continue to do in our lives. Father, we worship you. Thank you for your loving kindness. There is none like unto thee. From everlasting to everlasting, you remaineth the same. All power are in your hands, and we give you praise. Be thou exalted, be thou magnified. Today and always in our life. Forgive us our sins, Lord. Teach us by your word, by your spirit, even this day in Jesus' name. Amen. Yes, we thank God it's another time to meet you again in the word of God. And today our Bible reading will be taken from the book of Numbers, chapter 33. We'll be reading from verse 50 to 55. Numbers chapter 33, from verse 50 to 55. Now, if you are with your Bible, if you are at Numbers and you are chapter 33, let's read from verse 50. Hallelujah. And scripture says there, Numbers 33, from verse 50 says, "And the Lord spake unto Moses in the plains of Moab by Jordan near Jericho, saying, Speak unto the children of Israel and say unto them, When ye are passed over Jordan into the land of Canaan, then ye shall drive out all the inhabitants of the land from before you, and destroy all their pictures, and destroy all their molten images, and quite pluck down all their high places. And ye shall dispossess the inhabitants of the land, and dwell therein, for I have given you the land to possess it." Verse 54, and it says, "And ye shall divide the land by lot for an inheritance among your families. To the more ye shall give the more inheritance, and to the fewer ye shall give the less inheritance. Every man's inheritance shall be in the place where his lot falleth. According to the tribes of your fathers, ye shall inherit." Verse 55 said, "But if ye will not drive out the inhabitants of the land from before you, then it shall come to pass that those which ye left behind remain of them shall be pricks in your eyes and thorns in your sides, and shall vex you in the land therein wherein ye dwell." Hallelujah. So today we are talking about fight. Yes, fight. Hallelujah. Fight. Why fight? Now, the background to our Bible reading from Numbers 33 this morning sits in the plains of Moab. And the Israelites were wandering in the wilderness. Yes, they have been wandering in the wilderness for 40 years. And they are just about conquering Canaan land. So they are getting final instructions or receiving instructions on how they are to take the land. God has promised them the land, but there were clear instructions they needed, and clearly that's what the scripture is all about. Praise the Lord. Now, if we scroll back a bit to Genesis chapter 12 and verse 7, Genesis chapter 12 and verse 7, now God speaking to Abraham. He said clearly, he said, "And the Lord appeared unto Abraham and said, Unto thy seed will I give this land. And there buildeth he an altar unto the Lord who appeared unto him." So several years back, God has already promised this land to Abraham and his descendants. So these instructions before they go into the land of Canaan and conquer it was just God fulfilling the promise he has made to Abraham. And so as the people of God, also God has given us a promise. As a child of God, when you enter into the covenant of a relationship with God, that relationship comes with a promise. Let's start with John 3:16. God so loved the world, his love made him to give. And it says, "Whosoever believes in him shall have what? Eternal life, and the means possible to receive it." Hallelujah. Now, as a people who trust in God, amen, we have a promise. And the promise is that there is a land waiting for us in which we are yet to inherit. In our own case, This land is a land flowing with all milk and all honey. Yes, like the Israelites, we have wandered. We have done all that fits our heart, that suits our spirit. What to think makes sense. Scripture says, there is a way that seemeth right unto a man, and the end thereof is death. So we have done all of this, and we have faced different times in our life, times of discouragement, all right? Times when we couldn't just stand the next thing happening around us, where the stories around us wasn't even palatable. And all around us in our country, in our city, where we find ourselves, there is something not good to think or to see or to accept. But you see, that's when the move towards Cana, the promised land, becomes very important, because the world we live in is not our home. God will eventually call us back to Him. Either Jesus comes or we'll go back to meet Him. So every hour, every minute that we spend dealing with life and these options, dealing with life and whatever it throws at us, the promised land beckons. So what are you doing about that promised land? You need to fight for it. But you can't fight for a land that you don't know, a land of promise that you don't have the past to get into. And that's why Jesus is knocking at the door of your heart. And He's saying, if you must conquer Cana, the promised land, if you must get into that land where God has promised us, then we must have a relationship with Him. So Jesus wants to be your Master and Savior. So why don't you allow Him to come in and sup with you? Call the numbers on the screen. I'll be there to pray with you and to walk with you. For Jesus loves you and He wants to do this fight with you all the way. God bless you and keep you. Amen. Amen.